Step one is find the thing that could scramble like an egg. The egg is the most ubiquitous protein on the planet. More people are eating an egg today than any other animal protein. We found a bean that's been in the food system for over 4,000 years called the mung bean that scrambles like an egg, and we're scaling that all across the US and all across the world. And we take the protein out of it by taking the bean, milling it into flour, and then taking that flour, spinning it down really fast so the protein flies off from the fat and the fiber and the starch. Then we take that protein, we add oil, water, some minor ingredients, pour it in a pan, and you got yourself plant-based omelet. Like finding something that scrambles like an egg, that was a bear. It took us about 4.5 years to find something that scrambled in the lab. So most plants, when you pour in a pan, just evaporate. But there is a particular kind of storage protein within certain varietals of the mung bean that when separated, gels at the right time and temperature. We'll bring a plant in, and then we're automating the process of looking at molecular properties like the weight of the protein or the secondary structure of the protein. Then we've also automated the process of looking at functionalities, like does it gel or foam or bind or brown? Then the second pillar of our technology is how do we figure out a way, once we find something good, how do we figure out a way to remove the protein at scale? So there's a lot of technology around how we spin it down, the particle size of how we mill it. Other than the technology, we got some top flight chefs and food scientists who just know really good food, who apply not some high-tech approach, but their knowledge of cuisine and palates, umami, to that technology, ultimately to make something that hopefully people like. Food is a big issue because growing up, I didn't eat very well. And when you don't eat very well in the United States, you spike chronic disease. When you don't eat very well in sub-Saharan Africa, you die. Ultimately, what we want to do though is to make it significantly below the cost of all other major sources of protein. Much more of a transformative global thing than it just is, you know, a thing for the developed world. The mission of the company is really try to figure out a way to make this food system that surrounds us every day to a lot of people is completely invisible. How do we make it kinder? Right? How do we make it less harmful? How do we make it healthier for families here and families around the world? You're not going to build a perfect food system, but you can make it a lot better, and you can make it a lot better in our lifetimes. And we feel like if we nailed this big category, we'll have at least done our part to try to make that happen.